Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. In 1888, 246 people in India were killed by some stone-like particles falling from the sky, and some of those particles had the size of a goose egg and they fell from the cloud. Those were hailstones, and today's question is, what are hailstones and how hailstones are formed? Are they frozen raindrops? Well, there is much more to it. Let's get into it straight away. And I promise to keep this explanation simple and comprehensive. We all have seen clouds, but we would not have noticed this king of clouds called cumulonimbus. It starts from around half a kilometer from ground and extends like a tower up to 20 kilometer. And believe me, all aeroplanes fly below 20 kilometer. And as we go higher and higher in the atmosphere, the temperature reduces and it becomes colder and colder. And what it means to us is that if the atmospheric temperature at the base of the cumulonimbus cloud is 30 degrees Celsius, in the top of the cloud, it can go as low as minus 60 degrees Celsius. And it is in these cumulonimbus clouds the hailstones are formed. Let us see how the formation happens. During day, energy from the sun heats the ground and the hot ground in turn heats the air close to it. When the air becomes warmer, it becomes less denser or lighter, and this warm air moves upward to higher altitude. This is called updraft. And remember, this warm air has a lot of water vapor or moisture in it, which remained as gas at lower altitude because of the higher temperature. But as the air moves to higher altitude, the temperature drops and the moisture in the air condenses into water droplets. As it continues to grow, the tiny water droplets grow larger and larger as more water from the rising air is added to it. And the growing droplets that make up the cloud become heavier and heavier. The cloud starts to look dark and gray, and the water droplets start falling down due to gravity as the rising air can no longer hold it due to its increasing weight. So now we have two things in the cloud, updraft or the air moving upward, and water droplets falling down. Wait, there is something more. Some of the water droplets which reach still higher altitude where the temperature is well below freezing point turns to ice crystals, and the air there becomes cooler and becomes heavier or denser and starts moving down. The downward movement of the air is called downdraft. So now we have all the ingredients in this cumulonimbus cloud for the formation of hail. 1. Updraft. 2. Downdraft. 3. Falling water droplets. And 4. Ice crystals in the top. And now what happens? The floating ice crystals try to come down under gravity, but the updraft does not allow this to happen. So they start moving up and down and here and there in suspended condition. During this movement, they come to contact with the supercooled water droplets, and these droplets freeze on the surface of ice crystal and add another layer to it. Like this, frozen layers keep on getting added to it and it is transformed to a hail. And as they gain more and more size and weight, finally the updraft may not be able to keep them floating and they fall under gravity to ground as a hailstorm. The typical motion of hail during its formation may be like this, but not confined to this. And stronger the updraft, more the time it stays in the cloud and larger the hailstorm would become. It's interesting to note that because of this type of random motion, two types of freezing may happen. In this region of the cloud, where the air temperature is just below freezing, when the hailstone collides with a drop of water, the water does not freeze on the ice immediately. Instead, the liquid water spreads over the hailstones and freezes slowly. Because the water freezes slowly, the air bubbles in the cloud can escape from the region, and this results in the formation of a clear layer of ice. Whereas in this region, where the air temperature is well below the freezing point, a supercooled water droplet freezes immediately, and this quick freezing does not allow air bubbles to escape, and this leads to trapped air bubbles in the hail, forming a cloudy ice. These two different types of freezing give them different layers like this, a snowy appearance and interesting shapes. So, a hailstone is a chunk of ice with layers of clear and cloudy ice. The size of these stones can be as small as a water drop and sometimes can be as big as a cricket ball. These stones, falling like a rain, can cause extreme damage to buildings, vehicles, crops, and even humans. So, next time when you spot this particle rain, be cautious, look for cover, and then enjoy this natural phenomenon. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked it. Please subscribe and support us and click the bell button to receive notifications about the future videos. Oh, I see a cumulonimbus cloud there. Let me go and check it out. Signing off, Science for Common Man.